We're starting this video at Rinyirru National Park on the east side of the Cape. It was called Lakefield National Park up until a few years ago. In fact, all the parks up here on the Cape have changed names to the original Indigenous areas, which is a good thing, except when I'm trying to pronounce them. We crossed the Han River, one of the major rivers along with the Kennedy and Normandy that flow through the park. All through this country are lots of lagoons and billabongs, which gave the park its original name. We managed to find a little campsite on the Kennedy River that was out of the way, and after getting over my fear of crocodiles, went looking for some interesting birds. We're going to be taking it easy and spending most of the trip looking at birds and other wildlife. All through the tops of these trees are birds, initially hard to see. Nearby, a leaden flycatcher was feeding, and then I thought I spotted a female, which is quite different from the male. But no, it's a speckled monarch. Both are insect eaters, and both from the same family. The next day, we stop at Red Lily Lagoon. These flowers are only found in two places in the park. They flower early in the morning. The leaves can grow to about 300 millimetres diameter. Notice how they all face north towards the sun. In the distance, I notice a peregrine falcon hunting out over the lagoon. They are impossible to get close to, as they just fly off whenever they see you approach. Later that day, we head up towards Musgrave Station, and I notice a small billabong off the side of the road and decide to have a look. A large flock of magpie geese were roosting in the paperbark trees. Magpie geese are found right across the top of Australia, and for me, they typify these northern wetlands. It's the start of the dry season and the water holes are drying up. As the year progresses, the birds will concentrate more and more on the few remaining water holes. I've often heard the call of the darter, and it's always the female that I hear. I'm not sure if this is always the case. You can tell the females from their white front. Nearby, a pair of green pygmy geese seem unimpressed with all the noise. In the distance, a comb-crested Jacana and her three little chicks feed. With these big toes, they are able to walk on the water lilies. These birds used to be known as the lotus bird. As the sun sets, a colony of fruit bats head off to feed for the night, and we retreat inside the van as a swarm of mosquitoes descend on our camp. Just back from the billabong in the surrounding dry woodland, Diamond and Peaceful Doves were eating seed in a recently burnt patch of ground. Both these birds are from the same genus, Geopella, which means ground and refers to the way they feed, like this. Nearby, a bar-shouldered dove, which is the third and final dove of the same genus. It sort of makes sense to the way they classify these birds. Interesting to see all three Australian species together. When we reach Musgrave Station, we decide to head out and explore to the west. At first, the road is reasonable. We come across a grass fire. It is common in northern Australia to burn off the grass to promote fresh new growth for the cattle. For the brown falcons, this provides an easy meal. They were mostly eating grasshoppers and other insects. Brown falcons vary in colour, from brownish black through to this pale bird, which is an old adult. Most of the falcons I've seen have always been dark, which are the younger birds. The road gets progressively worse. and finally impassable when we reach the Mitchell River. We return to Musgrave Station and head north into Cowan to refuel and camp the night just out of town. Next morning, we head to what was the Archer Bend National Park and settle into camp by the river for a few days. A pair of forest kingfishers greet us. The male has a white collar right round its neck, where the female, the collar is broken by blue on the back. Next morning, I went for a bit of a walk in the riparian forest. These next birds were quite a challenge. This is the elusive male. And the male with a dusky honey eater. And finally, this is the female. They're a pair of shiny flycatchers. The next morning, we press on and turn east to Iron Range. They found minerals here, hence the name, but never in sufficient quantities to make it economical. As we pass a desolate swampy area, I notice some interesting plants on the side of the road. These are the pitcher plant. They're carnivorous and are filled with a digestive juice for any insects that might fall in. This park is unique in Australia, for it preserves a very small area, less than 100 kilometres by 100 kilometres. A tiny piece of rainforest, all that's left, which was once part of the jungles of New Guinea. Though slightly Australianised over time, it is our only lowland forest still existing. It contains plants and animal species found nowhere else in Australia, and for some species, nowhere else in the world. There are some 13 bird species, which are only found here. With only one access road and a few small walking tracks, access to the forest is limited. This and the dense canopy of vegetation will make bird watching very difficult. Still, for the native animals, this probably is a good thing. Later that day, we had an Australian brush turkey walk right through our campsite. You often see these birds hanging around campsites. They seem unafraid of people. What's interesting about this bird and the ones that live up here on the Cape is that they have this purple collar around their necks. It's a subspecies called Purpura collis. For the rest of Australia, they have a yellow collar, like these we filmed on the way up here, just out of Townsville. Later on, I came across a mound where they lay and incubate their eggs. Finally, some red-cheeked parrots arrived. These birds are only found here in this little rainforest region, so this is a real find. They are also found north across Asia. Thank you. the end of the road is a little town simply known as Portland Road. We camp nearby at Chilli Beach in the national park. In the next episode, we continue north, up the infamous Overland Telegraph track, to the tip. And I get to film the palm cockatoo, the largest parrot found here in Australia.